Hi there, welcome back to CSSCasts, learning the flexbox, an expert CSS author guide. Well, in this entire chapter, you learned about flexbox. I mean everything the flexbox has to offer in the game in order to make your life as easier as possible with lots of code demo examples. Well, now in this particular movie and upcoming few movies, I'm going to show you some real world problem solved by flexbox very easily. So now in this particular movie, I'm going to show you that how you can align any content in perfect center of your web page. Yeah, this is a really common problem we have faced as a web designer in our daily life. So now let's see how flexbox solved this problem. So for that, what I need to do here is, first of all, you can see here, this is a completely empty body here. So what I can do here, I can simply just get back to here. You can see this is the preview of this page, and there's nothing you can see here apart from this title here. So let me get back to here. And first of all, I'm going to create a simple, like, you know, like a H1 tag here, and I'm going to place my name, Rahul. Well, I want this name to be aligned in perfect center and as responsive as possible. Well, you know, this is a very short here, so it doesn't matter if I make it responsive or not. But I want to align it in perfect center. How do I do that? Well, I can get back to here, and here in style.css, I can simply get back to where I can say here HTML and body, and I'm going to make their height to be 100%. So height 100%. That's it. Now I can get back to here, and I can simply just go to body here, and in this case you can see here I told you in this chapter many time that if you want to align any content, then you can simply apply display flex property to its parents. Now in this case the parents is body, so I can simply go to here, I can simply say body, and I can say here display flex here. So display flex, and now I can simply just get back to here. You can see now you can't see the difference here, but now I can simply get back to here, and now you know that how can I use the cross axis alignment and main axis alignment. Well, if you are not sure, then go ahead and watch that movie on that aligning your content on main axis and cross axis. Great. So here you can simply say align items here, and here you can see here center, and now if I get back to it, you can see now it's actually aligned it right here. So by default the main axis is horizontal, and you can see I'm using this align item, and align item is used to just align any content in flexbox container on cross axis. So in this case the cross axis is vertical, so you can see it's vertically pushed down and align the center here. Now I can use justify content to align it to main axis. So justify content, and now again I can select center, and that's it. If I go to here, there we go. So now we can see, just like, you know, like three property here, we have just aligned this in perfect center. You can see if I just go ahead resize it, it still doesn't matter. You see, it is perfect center. This is so fantastic. So now let me create a user card, and then we can actually simply align it here. So what I can do here, I can simply get back to here, and let me just go to here, and I can simply just go ahead get rid of this guy, and let me create user card. So user card here, right, there we go. And in user card, what I'm going to basically here, I need here two child, and the first one is gonna be user info. So user dash info, I think you know, this is fine, user info. And the second one is gonna be user bio, I guess. Yeah, that's fine, cool. So this is just for demo purpose. Okay, fine, image, and I'm going to place her image. For that, let me go to here, and let me just search for placeholder image here, there we go. And let me go to this lorem pixel here, that's perfect. And here I can simply just grab any, like, you know, image I like. So I can simply just go ahead, let me grab this sports here, and I can simply change it to, like, you know, cats, right? You know that by now. Okay, simple. So I can simply say here cats here, and here I can simply say 100, and this is gonna be 100. That's it. Yeah, you know that. You can simply just go to here, and I can simply say h4 here, and I'm going to say it here like a Jane Doe, or I can simply, like, you know, username. It's really fine. And here I can just get back to here, I can simply just create a paragraph, and I'm going to just fill it with something like a like 25 words. There we go, perfect. If I go to here and if I reload it, there you go. So you can see there's actually our image name, and there's actually our bio. Great. So now what I'm going to do basically here, let me first make this little big here, perfect. Cool. Now what I can do, I can just simply get back to here, and now let's go ahead and just style our card. So I can simply just get back to here, and here first of all I'm going to just make this one is one column and this one is another column. So what I can do, I can simply just go to here and I can just grab this user card, because now I want to align this two child item here, and I can simply just go to here, say user card, and here I can simply say display flex. And there we go. If I just do that, cool, perfect. Now this is user card, so let me just make their width to be something like 400 pixel. There we go, perfect. And now you can see there's actually let's add some like margin here. So what I can do here, you can see this is actually user info. I can grab this one from here and I can simply say dot user info, and I can say MR margin right. Let's actually give it something like 1 m. And there we go, we got some margin here, perfect, cool. Let me just go to this here, and here I'm going to just, let me add some margin top here. So margin top, here we go, 1 m, and if I just do that, you can see we got this in align perfectly here, perfect, cool. Now let me get back to here, and now let me just give user card something like a background color, and this is gonna be material design card background here. There we go, FI, perfect. Let me add some border radius here. So this is gonna be border radius here. This is gonna be something like a, let's make this 5 pixel here. This is gonna be very simple here, perfect, cool. Actually now let me just add some shadow here. So for that I can simply just say here material card box shadow here. And I just go to this code bin here. This is really a nice library. Actually I have also used in this particular chapter here a lot of time. So I can simply just go ahead, grab this box to shadow, right? And I don't want to type this one because you will don't understand if you are beginner. So I will actually dedicate entire chapter to box shadow here, right? Cool. I can simply just go to here, and now you can see, there we go. So now we got a shadow to our card, perfect. Let me just add some border radius to this image here. So I can simply just get to here, image, and set here border radius here, and this is gonna be 50%, perfect. Now reload it, and there we go, perfect. Now let me just align this h4 here, you can see in center this one. So I can simply say here let's say here h4 and text align center. There we go, perfect, cool. And now let me just make this font family to be a little bit awesome here. So font family, let me make this Arial here, cool. See, now that's really fantastic, cool. Now let's add some padding to our user card here. So for that I can simply just say here padding, let's add 1 m, see how it looks. So you can see now this looks pretty fantastic. Actually it's a whole lot of padding here. Let me actually make this 0.5 m, there we go. And yeah, perfect. I just want to add some shadow here. So for that what I need to do here, actually I get back to it, I'm just going to add this card for a shadow to this user image here. So I can simply say here, right? And if I just go to here and if I reload it, there we go, cool. Now I can get back to here, and let me just say here dot user card dot hover. So anybody hover on here, just go ahead and just add this box shadow. See, if I have this one, see this box shadow, it's really fantastic, cool. Let me actually add some background here, so it's going to look really nice. So for that I just go to up here, I can say flat UI color here. So here actually I used it a lot here, and I can just go ahead copy this guy over here. I can go to this body here and set here busy, and there we go, perfect. And here we go, perfect, cool. So you see, let's have this one, this look really nice. So now this is the card. So you can see here, if I just go ahead and if I resize it, you can see it's actually pretty responsive. See, it's very responsive here. This is so fantastic, it's really crazy. I mean, if you want to just make it complete center, it's really fine, but if you want to place it right here, 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 just one property away, you can simply just say here, okay fine, I want this user card to be something like a go, like, you know, in here, or simply like, you know, center end here. So you can simply just say here like center. So this is justify content. So now you want to just align it in main axis, so you can simply just go to justify content here, and you can simply set here like a flex end here, and if I just do that, you can see now it's actually centered to here. This is perfect. If you want to just set here flex start, There we go. You see, it's now in start. If you just want to align it on this cross axis, yeah, you know, you can simply just go to here, set here flex, let's say here start. There we go. And now it's actually going to just align it here. So this is really fantastic. And let me just show you that if I just place your center here, and if I just go ahead and let me just place this center here. There we go. It's now in complete center. But now if I just go to here, and before doing so, let me just add some social link here. So it's going to be very simple here. So for that, let me just go to this font awesome here. Font awesome here. And here, let me just go ahead, there we go, and let me add some CDN here. So I'm going to just add this font awesome in my code via CDN, I mean content delivery network. So I can just simply copy this guy over here, and I can simply just go to here, and I can simply just get back to here, and I can simply paste it here. There we go, perfect. And I can simply just say here, okay, let me go to here, and let me icon here, and here I search for social here. And there we go. So you can see there's a Facebook square here, there's a Twitter square, there's a Google Plus square here. So I can simply get back to here, and I can simply say here like, okay fine, I'm going to just use this UL and LI, and here I'm going to create a simple like, you know, this font awesome icon. So I can simply say here I dot FA. So here I can say FA Facebook, and dash here I can simply say square here. So there we go. And now if I just go ahead and create this three here, so here I'm going to say here Twitter here, so sorry, Twitter, right? And here I'm going to say here Google Plus, so Google dash plus. There we go. If I just go to here, and if I resize it, sorry, reload it, if I reload it, you see now you can see this icon here. This is fantastic. So now I just want to align this icons in this horizontal, so I can simply just go to here. You can see this is UL. Well, if you want to assign a class here, you can do that. Or you can simply just go to here, and now there's a one single UL, so you can simply just go ahead and just because UL is a parent, you can simply say display and just set it to flex. And now you can see now it's actually in row here. First of all, let me just get rid of this bullets here. So for that, I need to go to this list here, and here I just say here list style, and let me set to none here. Right, perfect. Let me actually, you know what, let me just make some room here so you can see it very clearly. Perfect. And if I go to here, if I reload it, and now you can see this is really cool. Now let me just go ahead and let me say here MR, I mean margin right here. Let me just make this 1M, and perfect, cool. And now I want to align this in end here, so I can simply just go to this parent here, and I can say here actually I want to align in main axis, right? So I can simply just go to say here justify content here, and let me just say here flex end. There we go. And now you can see it's now going to align it in a very end here. So now you can see this is really nice. Yeah, so there's a picture, there's actually a name, there's a bio, and there's a social link. So yeah, this is really fantastic. And even if I just go to here, and if I just go ahead and you can see this user card, if I just make this copy here, and if I just create another user card here, if I just go ahead paste it here, now you can see here, now this is still aligning in very, very center here. This is really fantastic. Yeah, you can simply just go ahead and space some margin here. So let me just do that. So I can simply just go to here. And because actually this is user card, right? Here we go. I can simply say here MR, and let me just place it 1M. That's fantastic, right? Now you can see there's a two user card. So you can see this is really fantastic. So again, if you want to just like, you know, just align it anywhere, you can just easily do that. So if you want to just, you know, place it into this end here, you can simply just go to this main axis and set here flex end here. It's going to really work fine. See, it's aligning end here. So this is really cool. I mean, you can see this is so damn nice. So you can just go ahead, and it's actually responsive here. You can just go ahead, and you can see it's not you know, that much responsive, but yeah, you know that you can simply just go ahead and use flex wrap here. So yeah, you can simply just get back to here, and you can simply say like, go ahead and use flex wrap. So let me just go ahead and say here like a flex wrap here, and let's make this wrap. And if I just do that, if I go to here, now you can see it's wrapping here, and it's perfectly working in the C. So, yeah, this is so fantastic, and I hope that you learn something from here. So that's why actually I created this video, so you can see how you can use these flexbox in real world, and even how you can just align your stuff in perfect center. So I hope you like it. If you have any doubt, let me know in the forum and I'll be here to help you. And yeah, please don't forget to write your review and rate this course. And yeah, thank you so much for joining this movie. See you in the next movie.